What is up everybody, my name is Sabyasachi Paul and in today's video I'll show you how can you make your own ethical hacking portable and lightweight home virtual lab where you can practice your ethical hacking skills, you can practice your pen testing skills, you can improve your cybersecurity knowledge and so on and so forth. Okay, so let's actually begin with our video without any further delay. And before beginning, let me just give you a brief overview, a brief theoretical knowledge about what actually we're going to do. So basically our whole virtual lab will be based upon a topic known as virtualization. Okay, so what is virtualization? Virtualization is actually a process or technique through which we can run multiple operating systems on top of our home operating system. Okay, actually we can run our multiple operating system just like any other software, like we run our PowerPoint, we have our Word, we run Excel, browser, VLC media player. Okay, similarly like every other software, we can run operating systems also just like any other software. Okay, without actually corrupting the hard disk, without deleting any files, without doing any modification to the host operating system, we just simply need to download one particular software, and through that software we can run a hell lot of multiple operating systems. Okay, so let's begin. Actually, how can we do that? So for that you will need this particular software, Oracle VM VirtualBox. You can also download VMware Workstation 15 Player. Both are for free, but this also come with a paid version, so it might give you a bit, you know, it's a bit heavy, I would say. It's a bit, you know, large file. Okay, so this is how somewhat a virtual lab will look like. I have different machine, but I'll show you on how to do in Oracle VM VirtualBox because it's completely free of cost. Okay, this also come with the paid version as well, but this is completely free of cost. So let me show you how can you do with Oracle VM VirtualBox because it's the best. Okay, I would say. So let me just uninstall first my Oracle VM VirtualBox so that I can actually show you how to download, how to install each and everything. Okay, so I'll just simply uninstall this. It asks for the permission and just give it the permission and it will uninstall my Oracle VirtualBox. Okay, so our VirtualBox has been uninstalled. So what we will do is we will just open any browser and just simply write Oracle VirtualBox and go for the first link, Oracle VM VirtualBox. Click in this big blue giant button and go for Windows. If you are working in Windows, if you are in Mac OS, simply click on Mac, and as I am in Windows, I'll click on Windows. So again, I'll cancel it, I've already installed. Okay, and now it's time for installing the operating system which we will use for ethical hacking purposes, right? So the operating system which we will use is either Kali Linux or Parrot Linux. So for this case, let me just show you with both the file only. I have Kali Linux installed, I have downloaded the file, but I'll show you how to get download. So simply click on download, scroll down and you will get a page like this, download Kali for the virtual machines. Okay, so just simply click on the red color button and you will be redirected in a page, and simply scroll down and you will get an option, Kali Linux VirtualBox image. Go for the first link. It's saying of 64-bit OVA, that is Open VirtualBox Appliance. So I'll just click on cancel because I've already downloaded it. And so you can do the same for the Parrot as well, Parrot OS, and go for the Parrot security. Click in the download. Scroll up, you can see IoT and cloud appliances. Again, scroll down. Server. And you can see select server. Click in this download now. Your file will be downloaded within a moment. Okay. Okay. So let me just show you how to install the Oracle VirtualBox. So I'll head over to my download section wherever I have downloaded it. So here's my file. I'll just simply click on it. Click on open. It will ask for the permission to set up. Click on next, 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 and yes, install. It will ask the permission. Give it that. Okay, so it will just tell like start Oracle VM VirtualBox after installation, click on finish, close this thing, and this is what your software will look like, your virtualization software. So what I'll do now is I'll just click on import, click in this icon and locate that file, that your Kali Linux or Parrot Linux file, whatever you downloaded, and I have in my this particular folder in this VBox OVA, the Kali Linux OVA machine, I have it. I'll simply click on open and click on next, click on import, click on agree, and your file will be imported. And meanwhile we can go and download our vulnerable machine. So for that simply go to Pentester Lab, okay, and click on the first link, and let me just close this. Click in this particular link over here, check out our free exercises, click in this and you will get a hell lot of machines, okay, these are enough for you to practice for the first time if you're a beginner. So just simply click on this two file that I'll download right now. You can download anything you want, but I'll go for web for pentester 1 and web for pentester 2. Simply click on web for pentester, go to the files section over here and click in this particular link here, so to download the ISO file over here. So I'll just click on cancel anyways, and same thing you can do for the web for pentester 2 as well. Go for the file section, click in this here, and your file will be downloaded, okay. And if you want to download some other machines as well, simply you can head to Vulnhub is a huge a huge repository, a huge place, contains as many as machine you want to download, contains many machines. Just simply click on all and you will get a lot of machine, okay. These are all vulnerable machine for you to practice. These are all, you can say, CTF machines also. You can download and practice as many as times you want, you can see, okay. So for example, you want to download a machine known as Kioptrix. Let me show you with Kioptrix. Enter and I get Kioptrix level 1, level 1.1, 1.2, whatsoever. Click on any one, scroll down, you will get a section of downloads. You can go and download any one of it. So you can download the RAR file as well if you want anything. Access denied, okay, no problem. You can download the torrent as well. The torrent will be downloaded and then you can install it from the torrent also. Or you can click on this mirror as well, you will, the file will be downloaded. Either ways you can do, okay. So let's actually see. Okay, so our Kali Linux has been imported, right? So let's do one thing, let's import our those web for pentester as well. So those were ISO files if you could remember. So just simply click on new, write like web for pentester, okay, click for Linux Oracle, everything is fine, click on next, click on next, click on create, click on next, next, create, okay, this will be created. Similarly do the same for the rest of the web for pentester 2 and as well. So I'll just simply click on the Kali machine, I'll click on start. Our Kali machine should get started. That's it. And here you can see our, it's showing us any error, implementation of USB2 controller not found. This could be incompatible version of Oracle VM virtual extension pack. Okay, so if you get this kind of error, I know what to do. Okay, but let me just show you. You can just go to any of the browser and go to Oracle VirtualBox page, click on download, scroll down and you will get a option for Oracle VirtualBox extension pack. Click in this all supported platform, double click on it, it will ask you to install, scroll down and I agree. Give the permission. It has been installed. Okay, now you can just click on this right click in this Kali machine. Go to settings and check for anything you want to change. Like, I don't want to change anything as of now. Everything looks fine to me. It's in NAT. You can keep it in bridge also. I'll make another video what is NAT, what is bridge and everything. So let's simply click on OK and let's see, is there any problem? Okay, so machine is running, right? So click on it, click on capture it, and if you just move your mouse, okay, we're getting this. Simply click on this particular, not to show the message once again, your machine will boot up, right? Simply wait for it. You can maximize it or wait. Just simply write the username Kali Kali, which is the, you know, by default user, by default credential for it. Go over here, click on this button and it will come over here like this. You can go to view also and click on full screen mode. Do not show this message again, switch, and your machine will look like this, as if you are working in the Kali machine also. And here is the controller. Over here you can control audio files. Okay, and I'll make another video how to, what is the feature of this Kali Linux, how to actually use it. But if you see, if you just click on this particular icon, you will see a hell lot of tools: information gathering, vulnerability analysis, web application, database, password, and many tools are there. Okay, there are lots and lots of tools. Now if you want to change your password for the Kali Kali user, similarly what you can do is, let me just zoom into it. I'll show you what you can do. Simply, if you see who actually are you, means which user you are using it, it's Kali, right? Because we entered the username Kali. Now if you want to change the password, simply write password, pass and WD for password. Click on OK. It will ask for the current password which you are using right now. So it's Kali, K-A-L-I, Kali. Click OK. It's asking for the new password. So let me just keep like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hit enter, retype the new password, 1 2 3 4 5, and hit enter. You must choose the longer password. Okay, so let me just choose like my name Sabya. Oops, I did something wrong. Sabyasachi and 2002 for example, and similarly. Okay, so I have kept my password. Click on OK. Password updated successfully. Okay, now how to ensure? For ensuring, simply you can just head over here. You can do like logout, and it will ask you for this prompt again. If I just write Kali and Kali one more again, if I just click on login, it will say your password is incorrect because I have already changed the password. So we'll give our own password. And if you just click, your password is changed. And in this machine, actually, you can perform your ethical hacking tasks, right? You can actually do whatever task you want to do, whatever thing you want to achieve, whatever, you know, cool stuff you want to perform, each and everything you can do very well. Okay, so let me just do like this and minimize it. Now it's time for the web for pen tester. Simply click on start, and another particular box will open. It will ask you for the file. Simply click on this button, I mean option or icon. Click on add, go for the file, and if I'll just head over to my web for pen tester file. Over here you can see web for pen tester 1. Simply click on open, click on choose, click on start. You can see it's as easy. There's no rocket science, only next. Nothing you have to click, nothing you have to do. Okay, simply just wait for a while, relax yourself, do not do any particular movement. Okay, do not touch any keyboard, do not press any mouse click, everything it will be there. Okay, so as you can see, it's telling like user and Debian. If you could see, I don't know whether you can see or not, so just click into it. Again, it will ask like to click in this, do not show this message again, capture, and you can write ifconfig. Okay, so this will basically give you the IP address of this machine. And to get out of the machine, as you can see, I am moving my mouse, but you see there is no movement, right? I am moving my mouse over here, you can see no movement is there. So what to do? You can just do like Windows button and your right control key on your keyboard, the right control, because we have two control in the left and the right. So Windows button and right control key, you will get your mouse back. Okay, now if I just click on over here, you will see there is no mouse. And again, Windows and right control, you will get your mouse back. Okay, so you can say it's 10.0.2.15. So go in this particular machine, Kali 10.0.2.15. Okay, so you can open your browser. Let me open Chromium if we have. Don't we have Chromium? Okay, we'll use Firefox as well, no problem. Any browser will do. I forgot, what was that? 10.10.0.2.15. Okay, simply go and write 10.0.2.15. Hit. Okay, it's telling HTTPS. It's not HTTPS, it's HTTP. I don't know why it's always tells HTTPS. It's HTTP. 10.2.15. What was that? I forgot. 10.0.2.15. 10.0.2.15. Okay. Still, it's showing problem. I don't know why it keeps telling HTTPS. Okay. Now, if you encounter this sort of problem, okay, close the tab. What you can ensure is to foresee your gateways. So another cool stuff is to see. Oh, oops. Again, at ifconfig, click on this. Check your IP address. It's 10.0.2.15. Okay. So what you can do is simply click on power of the machine and turn off your machine. Turn both of the machine. Click on power off. Simply right click. Go to settings. Go to network, click on NAT and change it to bridge adapter. Click on OK. Simply do the same for this particular thing as well. I'll make another video, what is NAT, what is bridge, what is internal network, host only adapter. I'll make another separate video for that. And now start your machine. Okay, so let's give the username. Let's log into our machine. Our machine will start. Let's grab the IP address. ifconfig. Now you can see the IP address has been changed. Windows control. It's 192.168.29.138. So if we just go to Firefox, or you can just go to your Windows browser as well. Let's see if it works. It should work. 192.168.29.138. If you hit enter, you can see Web4 pentest has been started. And over here you can practice as many as thing you wanted. For example, if you go to SQL injection, you can do your stuff. You can do all your whatever you wanted to do. I have made a video on how to do SQL injection as well, so you can just go and check those out. I have made a video on XSS also. Okay, so I hope this was helpful, and there are lots and lots of things you can do. Go and explore. You can do the same for here as well. If you go for like 10, no sorry, not 10, it was 192.168.29.192.168.29.138. Click on OK and you will see web for pen tested. Okay, and you can again go and exploit it and everything. Go to example one if you feel like, just grab this IP address, go to Kali Linux, and you can do your exploitation. For example, I'm not showing you an, you know, how to actually perform SQL injection, because I've already covered another video, but I'm just showing you what actually the usage of it. You can simply go like this and simply you can exploit your things. Your hacking will be started. Now you should know what you're actually trying to do. Do not just blindly write any commands, because it's a Kali Linux machine, it's a hacking machine, and you will be responsible for whatever you do, because it is made for this hacking purposes only. And you can see we have databases like exercises, and you can just go into these particular databases, extract the file. So let me just exploit this particular thing for you. Just simply go, we get users. Click on users. Do we get anything? Yeah, we get something. Or we don't. Did we give the right thing? Users. Let's do. Oh, sorry. I did not write the main thing. That is dumb. That's why it was not coming. Here we can see the ID, group ID, age, name, password. Okay, so this is what you can do with Kali Linux. This is your attacking machine. This is your machine through which you can do your hacking stuff. You can perform any attack through it. As you know, what is the power of Kali Linux? You have heard it before also. I assume this is your not first time you're listening for Kali Linux. Okay, and this is your vulnerable machine, so nobody will catch you. This is your simulation environment. You can practice ethical hacking, and this is all for today. I hope you liked the video, and if you did so, then please like it, share with all your friends, and please do the drill. Like this video, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you want to see videos like this. And this is all for today. I hope you liked it. Goodbye, good night, and see you guys on the next one.